Hey guys, welcome back to Caveman Mining. I hope everyone is well and having a great day. On today's video, I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about my plans with my mining farm here in the Caveman garage location. About the physical logistics of my farm, nothing is going to change here in the Caveman garage, but in terms of my plans, I decided that I have dubbed and dedicated the month of December as the month of Ravencoin. And the two reasons why I deem this month of December appropriate for Ravencoin is two things. One is there's going to be a halving happening in January of 2022.
One, two, three.
And the other is the Raven, the story from Edgar Allan Poe, actually took place in December.
Quoth the Raven.
Nevermore.
Why, you little...
Maybe both of those things will bring me a little bit of luck, because although I am switching over to Ravencoin, I am also going to be doing solo mining using my farm here, which consists of an 8-card mixed rig here of NVIDIA and AMD cards, as well as the test bench that I have. I'm going to take that RTX 3060, put it back on the hanging rig, so that would complete the 5 cards total back on that hanging rig, which we've got 2 RTX 4000 cards, a 6600 and a 6600 XT. So we'll get that, I guess, horsepower added to Ravencoin. Everything you see here right now is mining Ethereum. We did some testing and a little bit of pool mining on Ravencoin with the 3060 light hash rate, but we will switch that back over, as well as all the other cards, to Raven. Now, I do have 2 other cards additional to what you see here. One is in the MSI laptop that you normally see me streaming off of. That has a 2060 in it. And then I have a desktop PC on my 3rd floor, which I use for gaming, CPU mining Raptorium, and I also mine Ethereum on it, because that 3060 is the original nerfed version, not the light hash rate version, so that gets the full 50 mega hash on Ethereum, which is nice. But you know, for the sake of testing, the sake of science, I want to scoop as much Ravencoin as I can. But I know there is a risk with solo mining, and the hopes is that when we switch everything over, we're going to hit a block or a few blocks. It would be nice. And the time frame that I would like to do this experiment in is do some solo mining for about a week. And then once we, you know, get an outlook on did we hit any blocks or what was the profitability solo mining, we will then do another week of pool mining with all of the cards, the same resource, to see what that compares to Ethereum mining as we're doing it today, and also comparing it against the profits of doing the solo mining first off. Part of dedicating some of these videos and content to Ravencoin, what we will do, probably not on today's video, but I want to, for some of the beginners out there, I want to show you guys in Hive OS and on kind of the PC end, or in general, how do you set up solo mining for Ravencoin? You know, so what we'll do is we'll do eventual live jump into Hive and a look into the PC on how you actually set up solo mining. And then once we do the solo mining, we'll also do another quick video on how to do pool mining, you know, how to set that up in Windows, you know, use the different miners, and explain a little bit about the pools and how they work, and the wallets as well. So I haven't really covered Ravencoin exclusively, although I have advised you guys, I have mined a little bit of it in the past. So we'll take a little bit more of an intimate look, rather, in terms of what I've already mined in total for Ravencoin, and maybe a prediction in terms of what we could be mining and the profitability based on that. And an added layer to all that, guys, you know I am all about the statistics and efficiencies, as well as we have the Space Goats power meter here. So when we get to those videos of doing the different mining solo and pool. Maybe we'll try out a few different miners as well. We'll do some power, you know, to see what the power looks like. So right now, just so you guys know, you know, we are mining all Ethereum on those, you know, 13 cards, what you see here in the basement. So we're pulling about 1,550 watts all on Ethereum. So clearly, you know, expect that to go up, right? I mean, it's, we know Raven is a much more power and core intensive algorithm. So it'll be interesting to see once we switch the farm over here, what that looks like. So we have a dedicated 30 amp circuit, and those are all connected, you know, down the line on the PDU that's down under the bench. So yeah, it'll be cool to see, you know, what's the wattage, what that looks like once we switch everything over, because I haven't done it at all as a test. So beyond the sake of, you know, testing out the rewards, we also know that, you know, when Ethereum goes, you know, proof of work goes away, you know, the thought is potentially switching over to Ravencoin and making sure that, you know, our rigs and our farms are outfitted in terms of power, capacity, and capability to be able to do that. So I actually think this will be a really good first test to be sure, you know, if the cards fall as they may in the future, that we can support that, we can be ready to do that, and we know that the farm has the ability to switch over to Ravencoin. So I think that will be also a cool test to really, you know, pre-test that scenario. So yeah, guys, I just wanted to, you know, provide a quick update on what I'm going to do here. I don't know if anyone out there has any suggestions or, you know, wants for Ravencoin. If there's anything explicit you want to see, let me know in the comments below. And like I said, I think on the next video, what we're going to do is jump a little bit more intimately into the Hive OS and into Windows to show you my rigs, how to switch them over in the software, and getting started on that. And then the thought is, you know, maybe in a couple weeks, we'll do some videos to reveal our findings for solo mining and switching everything over in pool mining. But with that said, guys, I will cut the video here. Please, you know, hit that thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and yeah, hope to bring some more cool content to you guys, and we will see you next time. Take care.